Well, I'm up here in one of my favorite spots, and I brought Bushwhacker up. I just finished overhauling the engine. It's got about 3.5 hours on it now, and I figured I'd shoot a little video of Bushwhacker. So here is Bushwhacker. Baggage area goes pretty far back in there. If I pull the seat out, there's about 8 feet of space in here, and I slept in here for almost 6 weeks while I was moose hunting up in Alaska. It's configured like a Super Cub. This is basically just a mall sling seat. I moved it forward because I could, so I moved it forward about 6 inches. And now, when you have a passenger, their feet just rest against this bar here. So if you got a single passenger, you know, they can slide from side to side or sit in the center line. And if you got two passengers, just like a mall would be, but their feet go alongside of me. And then it still has the big double doors like a mall would have. Interior-wise, it's got heel brakes and rudder pedals like a Cub. Kind of did the same style of brake cylinder as what my Super Cub has, but it's just a little bit different setup. Then I'm using a reservoir, running an EarthX battery. Fiberglass floorboards with a Nomax core. Had to reconfigure everything. So, you know, I went from a yoke to a stick, changed the angle of incidence to much greater than a mall, actually more than a Super Cub. These are like little grab handles to get in. Move the trim up to the dash. A torque tube type flap system, so it's a direct drive. So when I bring the flaps on, they come down quite substantially. There's no reflex because it is a direct drive, so you don't get any cable reflex when you push on them. So whatever you pull on, you get. It's got gull wing style doors. I'm running 35-inch Bush wheels also. And I built my own Oleos, and they're quite a bit different than Mall's Oleos. And then it's got a Cub style cowling. Had to build my own Dynafocal engine mount. I'm running a IO360 C1C. It originally came out of a Piper Aero. I just overhauled it, so replaced all the required parts. And then I put 10-to-1 pistons in it. Substantially more horsepower than it had before. I can tell already. It was tired. It had 3,300 hours when I pulled it out to overhaul. Running an 80-inch constant speed propeller with a compact hub. Extended landing gear. In fact, airframe's landing gear is built off of my design. I used a little Super Cub step to get in. Both doors open. I made an airfoil style horizontal, and then it was adjustable for my testing purposes. And then once I got it set where I wanted, now it's fixed. And then I have a trim tab, just like a mall would have. It's got the biggest wing mall ever built, and I extended each of them 1 foot. I added it all to the aileron, and I actually shortened the flaps. The flaps were originally 126 inches. They're now 114 inches, and the ailerons are 90 inches. I'm running all four tanks, so I got 66 gallons of fuel, Dakota Cub fiberglass wing tips. It weighs 1,059 empty. Custom exhaust in California built the exhaust for it. Oh, these are my lightweight wheels. I machined them out of solid billet. They're the first set ever built. And then I drilled the brake disc. Lighten them up a little bit more. This is a fuel injected engine, if I didn't say so. I had to find the nose bowl that would work with this wide engine, because an angle valve is a little bit wider than a parallel valve. And the guys that build the Grizzly Cub, or I'm trying to think what the name of it is. I'll think of the name. Anyway, they were kind enough to sell me one. Baby bush wheel on the tail. I got a carbon fiber belly pod for it, which isn't on right now. It has a metal belly for the back section that gives you access and, you know, you don't tear up the fabric. Anyway, let's go out and do some flying. If you enjoyed what you watched here, please subscribe and hit the like button.